course, it also confuses people so that if, you know, one of us says something stupid, we just hide behind the other.
Oh, that's not, that's right.
Who's the other guy?
Do you do that all the time?
You'd be amazed when people think they're only two of us here in the studio.
Well, I know, and so I often say, no, that must have been the other half.
I was very annoyed at the Dow this week. On Tuesday, May 28th, the Dow closed up 106.29 points. 106.29, it closed up. On Wednesday, the next day, it closed down 106.59 points. It was like, what?
You just show up at work on Thursday.
Exactly. If you went away on Monday, came back on Thursday, it was just happening. 106.29, 106.59, up and down two different days.
Sounds like a radio station.
All right, let's take some telephone calls. Wilma has been very patient, calling from Maryland. Hi, Wilma. How are you?
Thank you.
Oh, run. You're on a speakerphone, Wilma. Pick up the telephone.
Is it okay?
Yes, it's perfect. Thank you.
Okay. I am a recipient of a 457 plan that was my husband's. And this year, for the R&D, the custodian wants to distribute it at a rate that I don't agree with. So I wanted your opinion.
All right, let me back up before you go further.
Okay.
A 457 plan is a retirement program typically available to municipal employees. Your husband worked for a government, local...
state.
Correct?
Yes.
And he passed away, and you inherited the 457 plan, and you are over the age of 70 and a half.
Yes.
And you are now taking distributions as required by the IRS. Called an RMD, required minimum distribution, and the amount of money you have to distribute is based on tables the IRS publishes.
Exactly.
You have to take a certain amount of money based on your age, and you don't agree with the calculation that your husband's employer has done.
I don't agree with the table they're using. They're using the inherited table, and I think they should be using the other table because it's a spousal distribution.
Wilma, is it still with the employer or is it in an I? So it's still a 457. Who's the provider?
The provider? Well, Nationwide is the custodian and Tesco.
Okay.
Maryland is the original.
And so what's the registration? When you look at the statement, does it say IRA of Wilma?
Transferred to my name, yes, many years ago.
Okay, you're right, Wilma. You should be using the uniform table.
It's from Appendix C, and it's the spousal table and not the inheritance table.
Right, it sounds like they're using the single table would be when a non-spouse inherits an IRA and it turns into what's called a beneficiary IRA.
Yes.
But as a spouse, you have the ability to make that retirement account your own, and you would continue to use the uniform table.
Doesn't this...
So how do I force them to change their mind?
Have you tried to talk to additional people instead of just the one person who's told you that it's going to be this amount?
No, every time I call in there...
Well, what's the difference in the actual amount of money being distributed between the amount that they're sending you versus the amount you think they should send you?
Oh, $7,000 a year. I think the factor they're using is like 16.1 and my factor should be like 25.6.
Wilma, do you have the ability to take the lump sum and roll it over to an IRA?
I do.
Then that is what you should do. Get fired then. Because this is a perfect illustration of why we argue that you should never leave money with a former employer. You have to deal with their bureaucracy, and Wilma is demonstrating their incompetency, and it's serving no value and no benefit. By rolling the money over to an IRA, Wilma now is in sole total control, not only of how the money gets invested, but